Hello guys and welcome to another tutorial, and in this tutorial we are actually going to make that you can instantiate this object. So the first thing we are going to do, I put those boundaries from the box collider. I did that wrong, and those are the variables that are that you are really need, so .4 and .8. And the first thing we are going to make is a new C# script, and you are going to call it preview object, like this one. And we are going to open it, and we are going to use list, so that's why this line is here. And well, let's just start. So the first thing we are going to need to know if it is a foundation. And the thing we are going to do is we are going to make a list of all the colliders the object actually hit, and if it hit too much, or if it hit any, you can't instantiate the object. So the first thing we are going to do is check if it's a foundation, and if you do this, you are going to make sure if it is a foundation, it can actually hit the ground without, and it can still instantiate the object. So that's why you are going to need this bool. And we also need a list of all the colliders that the object is hitting. So this is this line about. And then you also need two materials, a material of green, which we created last time, and also a material red, which we also created last time. Whoops. Yeah, that's better. And we also need a bool if it is buildable. Wait a minute. Is buildable. So it will add a collider if this trigger will enter another collider. And an important thing is that you got your layers like this. Because we are going to use layer 9 if they hit the collider of one object that's standing on layer 9, you can't create the object. So you need to have on layer 9 the buildable layer. And the first thing we are going to do is on trigger enter. On trigger enter, it needs also needs between those two brackets, it needs a collider called other, and if the other came object and from that layer is 9 and it is a foundation, it will add to the list this collider. And if the collider will exit the trigger, so on trigger exit, so also collider other, it will remove it. And of course this line is exactly the same, because we still need the same objects, only now we need to remove it. So remove other. So now we need to know if it if is something is standing in the list, the object will be red, and otherwise it will be green. So it will be buildable or not. So we're going to make a new void for that, and it's called change color, and it will check if in the collider list the count will be equal to 0. If it is buildable is true. Otherwise it isn't buildable, because there are more than 0, so is buildable is false. And we are going to create it in another if else loop. We are going to create that if it is buildable for each transform child into this dot transform. Wait a minute. In this dot transform, it is it needs to change the material to cream. Also, I forgot to put here some. Well, I messed it a little bit up, but so if for each child, and on the cat component render from it, and from that we will change the material to cream because it is buildable. We are going to do exactly the same with the else loop, and we are going to change this to red, and that is everything for this. Wait, one thing more for this script, because we need to update it every second. So for that we need to add here change color, and that's everything for this script. And in this script we are also going to need to change a little bit. The first thing is, we are if it is buildable, we can then we can build it. So first we're going to make a void of where it will check if it is buildable, and also if it is, it will directly build the object of instantiate the object. So preview object bo is from the current preview, so that's the object which is previewing the object, and that is and will get the component from it that is preview object. So you'll get a script of that object, and with that we are going to use it in this part. We are going to check if it is buildable, so that's the variable we assigned in this script earlier this tutorial. And if it is, it will directly instantiate the object. And what is the object? It is of course this object we just created and put in our Rust prefabs folder. So you're just going to need it like this and then drop it. And we need for each different object, we need another preview, another game object. And so we are going to call it public game object prefab. So we are going to instantiate from the current object the prefab, and it is on the current position, and we aren't going to do anything with the rotation, so just change to this. And now we need only if it need only to call this function, and we are going to do that in the update function, and that is when the when the input dot cat button down, so only if it is down, so that you can't instantiate a lot of objects at the same time if you just hold your button. So that's why it is cat button down, and it will be fire one, and that's the standard name for your left mouse. And if it is, we are going to build it. So now we need one last thing to do, and that is we are going to add to the preview the script, and that is called preview object, and it is a foundation, and we are going to add here preview G and preview R. Whoops. And here preview R. Come on. Yeah. And after that we're going to hit apply, and we are also going to change this one here to this one. So the prefab is foundation, and after that just check it. I hope if we hit the left mouse button like this, it will instantiate. As you can see, it can build right now it, and it will and you can just build the whole foundation of this. So that was all for this tutorial. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please like and subscribe, and if you got any question, please ask below in the comment section, and I see you guys next week.